What's up, everyone? We are here again at the Reitium stage here in Toronto, Canada at the Great Collision Conference with my friend Parsa. Parsa, thank you for joining us.
Great to see you, Eric. It's been a while, eh?
Yeah, great to see you. So could you tell us about your company, Dyne? What is the company? What does it do?
So simply put, we grow restaurant revenue by connecting people over the love of food. Now, are you a foodie?
Of course.
I love food. You like meeting people over food?
Yeah, of course.
That's what we do. You know, in just five clicks, our app connects you with like-minded individuals using AI recommendations, gamified map-based features, and the best deals in each of our five cities. With over 10,000 users right now, we created this dine-in data set that helps restaurants grow their revenue through analytics. And we're currently in five cities and expanding to Toronto and Quebec this quarter.
Okay, wow, that's really interesting. So 10,000 users. How did you acquire your 10,000 users?
Well, you know, we're a company built by students, for students, run by students. So we've really seen the student community affected by this problem from the pandemic. You know, 80% of us are feeling lonely, and 70% of restaurants went bankrupt. And you can imagine what one bankruptcy does to one restaurant. Multiply that across a million restaurants in North America, and it's a huge problem. So we created this solution that helps us and helps restaurants scale up their, you know, business, grow the revenue, and helps users connect and get great deals on food as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And so how did you, you know, one day wake up and say, I'm going to help restaurants increase their revenue by driving community into their restaurants?
You know, it was the craziest thing. We started just from the B2C angle, looking at users, how we can connect users. And restaurants were like, hey, you guys are bringing people into our doors. We didn't even ask for this. Thank you so much, first of all. Second of all, can we make this more, you know, autonomous, more AI driven? Can we have more analytics? Can we see what's going on? Can we make this more formalized? And we're like, okay, so there's something here. We had no idea. You know, we were college students at the time, right? So we're just, you know, a couple of, you know, junior students doing, you know, some summer project. All of a sudden, became this huge thing that now has this traction, and we're growing fast, and it's been the greatest time of my life.
Yeah, and so what is the revenue model for the, do the restaurants pay to be on this offer?
A lot of people try to make foodie apps, but no one does it correctly. This is because they try to charge the users. We charge restaurants. We have three revenue streams of having a SaaS subscription, commissions on all orders placed, as well as an event share, price sharing model. So this helps restaurants, you know, really see an incentive-based payment structure and really pay us for what we're providing them. And it keeps users' pockets full because we provide discounts and deals for them to go on more meetups and using our app more. So it really allows us to focus on restaurants paying to scale up and users get a free app, which is pretty good.
Yeah, absolutely. And so what drew you out to Collision? What about this conference did you say, we got to be there, we got to get boots on the ground?
Well, I mean, beyond just meeting you here.
Yeah.
You know, we really want to make sure that we can establish this product across Canada and the United States. Currently, we're in Vancouver, Kelowna, Edmonton, Bellingham, and Seattle. And we're trying to do our East Coast expansion. So Toronto, currently, we have 50 restaurants and the best deals in the city so far. We're really scaling up. We've seen around 500 to 700 users just download the last couple of days. So we're trying to scale up on the East Coast, as well as, you know, announce our seed round of $1.5 million. Get some.
Wow, congratulations.
Yeah,
there you go.
Yeah, we already have around 800 cases secured, but hopefully we can fill that up and maybe even oversubscribe from day two and really scale up across Canada in the next 6 months.
Yeah, absolutely. And so what, now that you've raised that seed round, what's the, or when you do raise that seed round, what's that next step of like, all right, is it product development? Is it boots on the ground marketing? Where are we going?
So we're definitely improving our product, making new AI algorithms to improve our recommendations and ensure that we create the best analytics. We're also going to new verticals. We're going to tourism. We're going to corporates. We're going to hospitality. We're expanding into all these different sectors where there's a community. We want to make sure the communities are built around dine, around food, at a table, the way we're doing right now. If we had, you know, a burger on the table, I think we'd have a lot more fun. But
some truffle fries is what I had last night, too.
Exactly.
And so where do people find you? What's the website, the socials, all that?
Yeah, so you can download us on Google Play or the App Store. Dyne, D-Y-N-E is our app. I guess you can also look at our website, dyneapp.ca. And, of course, we'll be pitching today at 5 p.m. So if you're in...
Good luck to that, yeah.
Crazy thing. We're in the semifinals. Hopefully we go.
Yeah, and if you went, you're in the top 12 now, and you'll be competing for the top three, right? That's crazy. Well, congratulations to you. And again, this is we're here live with Dyne at the Toronto Collision Conference.
Take care, everybody. Slowing down the dance, do a different type of speed. Here we are.